With me in studio is the man who has been at the center of all this action, and that is none other than Betty Hammer Jackson, Chairman Putsif. Welcome to Weekend Prime News Live.
Thank you, madam.
Okay. Now, putting aside all that we've heard you talk about, could you give us more details of what you talked about with the IGP?
The IGP has invited us on the issue of public order management because there was a sort of, scuffle, because we are entering into a weekend where all public universities were going to open and the students would come and there was no non-teaching staff to receive them. So intelligence had shown that there would be strikes all over because of students without attention of the workers. So we agreed that we equally don't want to affect the students, the public, and the parents. And the government had intimidated us, giving directives through councils that if you don't report, they will sack you, they will do what. That's not why we accepted. But we agreed that in the interests of public order management, let us agree and resume work, but for only 1 month. We gave the IGP only 1 month, which is expiring on 20th of September, bearing in mind that if the government fails to address our concerns, we shall put down our tools. And I call upon the government to make sure that they continue to engage us in the negotiations. The Prime Minister's office should get serious and make sure that at least this issue is resolved. Again, we have received information that His Excellency the President is equally willing to meet us within 2 weeks. And therefore, we believe if he could meet us and resolve this problem, it will be better because he's the one who enhanced the academic staff, and we believe he's able to enhance us too. It should be really known that a university system operates in a teamwork. And whereas the university has three categories of staff, that is the academic staff, the senior administrative, and the support staff, these three teams need to operate together as a system. So there is no way you can enhance the academic staff leaving the other two categories and the system operates normally. Of course, there will be paralysis that has been happening. So okay. I believe this will be amicably ironed out.
Now, looking at the current situation, are you optimistic that government will handle your issues in the next financial year?
Yeah, we believe so, bearing in mind that if the government gets serious and gives us as a priority, it can, because education is an investment, and the government should give it priority, because university education focuses on teaching, research, and the consultancy. And the university is a workshop, it's a workshop of the economy. This is where we give an output that goes into the society to spearhead development and innovations. So really I believe that whereas the president is looking at roads, energy, whatever, all this depends on the human resource you have to run the economy. And the human resource just comes from the quality of the products of the university. And therefore, I believe his focus should also get attracted to universities.
When did you get to know about this problem?
We happened to know that we had been eliminated or discriminated in enhancement in a period of March this year. And the government was still budgeting. So we petitioned the office of the Prime Minister. But we had earlier written to our vice chancellors to make sure that they engage the government on our behalf. However, they relaxed, and we had to take it upon. And as a chairman of all public universities, I got into it seriously. I organized all public universities. We came together, and we started this move. We wrote to the Prime Minister. He never gave us a feedback. We also petitioned the Parliament. Right Honourable Speaker of the Parliament, Madam Kadaga. And from there, the Parliament has also not given us its opinion. So we are surprised to find that the parliament passed the budget without increment, and that's when we gave a notice for industrial action. And it was not an ambush to find that on 3rd August, all universities put tools down and they were paralyzed and closed immediately.
Okay, now in the interest of time, could you tell us briefly, should the government fail to honor its promise, what will be the next step? What should we expect?
That will be disastrous. I want to tell you, let come 20th of September, should the government make a mistake and fail to have come with that agreement, then we shall put tools down and that will be chaotic because students will be at campuses. And if we abandon them, I don't know really what will happen. I don't even want to imagine what will happen because it will be disastrous, it will be horrible, and I believe really the public would regret.
All right. Thank you so much for honoring our invitation. Hope you'll do the same next time.
Thank you very much. I'm grateful.
All right. We now take a short break and we'll return with more news. Keep it WBS.